Now, if you use Photoshop or Illustrator, it doesn't really matter because you've probably missed out on some tricks in these Adobe programs. And that's what I'm going to show you in today's video. And that starts right here in Photoshop. So this is the wrong way to do something that a lot of people actually do in their workflows. They make a selection of something and then they use the Alt Option key to duplicate it all over their design. Doing things this way takes a long time and the end result looks pretty poor. But this is what we do instead. Grab the Marquee tool and then make a selection over your object like this. Then hit up the Edit and Define path to open this window. Give a relevant name to your object pattern and then hit OK. Now simply press Command or Control D to cancel your selection. And we come back into Edit and this time we're going to use Fill. Now you want to use the pattern option in contents and in the custom pattern, choose the one that you've just saved. I like to use the random fill for this script here and make sure to keep the blending mode set to normal and then you're ready to go. So in the new window, the first four sliders will dictate the style and orientation of your arrangement. And for the desired effect I'm going for, keep the bottom two sliders set to zero. And there you have it, a random pattern of my object in a matter of seconds. Pretty cool. Now we're stepping into the world of vectors with Adobe Illustrator. This is a relatively new feature and it was actually possible in older versions, but it was a giant headache and just an annoying workaround. So now when you're designing something, you can actually come up to Object, Repeat and Mirror. Whatever you're working on will be mirrored over to the other side of this line. And I personally find this so awesome for creating symmetrical logos or shapes that are symmetrical such as arrows and so forth. Now it simply just saves a bunch of time and we can be 100% certain our design is symmetrical. And when you're done, just click the grey bar at the top to release the mirror UI and bingo. Just like that, symmetrical icons ready to use. And in this segment of the video, I have an awesome opportunity to share with you via a highly acclaimed university. If you're a designer who wants to further your skills and understanding, and maybe you feel like you have a solid foundation of basic knowledge as a designer, but you wish to take things to the next level, then Labasad Barcelona School of Arts and Design could be a great option for you. Labasad is the only exclusively online design school that is 100% live. This gives students an in-person experience in an online format. They guarantee a unique, high-quality learning experience across the board. They have an excellent online master in graphic design and applied typography. But one of the really beneficial things is that the co-directors of the master are Marina Soto from Barcelona and Mark Bloom from London. They are both graphic design and art director experts, and Mark Bloom has actually worked for clients such as Coca-Cola and Nike. They also have a team of highly experienced teachers, such as professionals from Area 17, designers who have helped craft and refresh visual identities for OpenAI or the website Balenciaga. At the Barcelona School of Arts and Design, they actually accompany their students throughout the entire program, so they're never on their own in the learning experience. And all of the instructors are currently working in their profession. They work for brands with global presence, such as Adobe, Starbucks, Apple, IKEA, and Netflix. This means they are actually in touch with the current landscape of the design world. You can enroll to the online Master in Graphic Design and Applied Typography for November. But if you'd like to learn more about it, there's a link in the description box below to a video from one of the directors explaining about the Master. Or you can just contact Labasad directly and ask for more information about it. But thanks again to the Barcelona School of Arts and Design for sponsoring this part of today's video. Now we're going to get back to more useful tricks and tips in Adobe programs. This trick in Photoshop is just so cool. So have a flattened design or image and then press Command or Control J to duplicate your layer. Now we want to isolate part of our design and you can do this in many different ways, but I'm selecting the subject and then using the quick selection tool to neaten up my selection. But when you're ready, create a clipper mask in the layers window like so. We need some typography, and for my design here, white is probably going to work best. Make sure you're happy with your text because we're now going to convert it to a smart object by right-clicking here. Move it into the middle of your layers, make a duplication, and move that one to the top. Crucially, on the top layer, bring the fill down to 0%, but leave the opacity at 100. Now we're going to apply a stroke to the top layer via the effects panel. And of course, you can apply whatever stroke you like. I'm personally going for a thin one here on my design. So with the top layer selected, hold down the Alt Option key until you see the icon appear between these layers, and then just click. Hold down the Command or Control key and select both layers and then link them here. Now you should have this cool text effect that whenever you move it, the mask knocks it out, which is really cool. I saw this one on TikTok a while ago, but I can't remember the original poster. But yeah, let's just step back into Illustrator for this next trick. Now, if you have a logo, a typographic or not, we can do some cool things with it. Select it and then come into the brushes panel. We are going to look at two different brushes, but first let's look at the art brush. Now these settings will work just fine for what we need to do today. Okay, so the cool thing is that we can actually press B for the brush tool and just draw out the logo in many, many different ways. This is pretty fun, and actually it can work well for certain branding materials for certain clients. We can also generate vector path shapes and apply the logo brush to them like so. Changing the stroke weight alters the logo itself, as you can see here. But let's drop the logo into the brushes panel once more, and this time for a pattern brush. You can experiment with these settings and it will depend on your design and what you actually want to do, but I'm going to run with these ones here. And let's generate a circle and apply the pattern brush to it. This time the logo is going to be repeated until it joins back again, and changing the stroke weight will increase or decrease the amount of times the logo is applied. And again, we can go wild with the brush tool and just print out the logo with ease in any kind of way we want. And yeah, this is pretty cool with logo symbols too. So we're back in PS for more rasterized fun, and this one is a real time saver. If you want to remove this dude from the background, you might opt for using the clone stamp tool, which will actually take a long time indeed. Instead, grab the lasso tool and make a selection around the things that you don't want to have on your design. You can hold down Shift to make multiple selections all at once. But when you have your selection, right click and use the Content Aware Fill option. You want to carefully remove any green areas that are covering your subject on the design. And you can change the brush size for this as well. Then click OK and just wait for the results to render in. It might not be perfect, but it's a really great starting point and it's a whole lot quicker than the clone stamp tool. And we're back in AI. This one's thanks to Will. When we want to export designs such as logos to screens, it's a quick and easy method to save a bunch of designs at once, right? But did you know there is actually a resolution setting here which allows us to save our designs at super high quality? It's one of those settings that is pretty hidden away actually. So this resolution setting is something not many people know about, but if you want to learn 7 new hacks in Illustrator, just click that video on screen. And until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.